Hello, my name is Beth Last, and I am a staff member at the Materials Characterization Lab at Penn State. Today, I will be giving a brief introduction to mechanical characterization. With mechanical characterization, you deform your material and you measure the applied load or force. There are a variety of different mechanical experiments, which include tension testing, where you pull on your sample, compression testing, where you compress or push on your material, a shear experiment, a bending experiment, as well as an indentation experiment. With mechanical characterization, there are a variety of experimental parameters that are measured. Of course, you measure your force and your deformation. During your experiment, you could also measure or change the temperature, the stress state, the environment, for example, like the fluid the material is in, the humidity or the gas or the pressure, along with other different experimental parameters. With mechanical experiments, you measure your mechanical response and your mechanical properties. Some examples of different mechanical properties include the Young's modulus, the storage modulus, the yield strength, as well as hardness, along with others that are shown here. With mechanical characterization, you do not talk about the load or force or deformation that is applied to your material because these parameters are dependent on the size of your sample. You need to normalize to remove any sort of scale factor. So for stress, which is your load divided by your cross-sectional area, and strain, which is your change in length over your original length, these parameters are commonly discussed rather than load or deformation. So with mechanical characterization, you actually are measuring the load and deformation, but you report your values in terms of stress and strain to remove that scale factor. Some different applications of mechanical characterization include this example that is shown here for an additive manufactured 316L stainless steel material. This sample was tension tested, meaning that it was pulled until it failed. Shown here is our stress strain curve with strain on the x-axis and stress on our y-axis. From this curve, you can calculate specific material parameters like your Young's modulus, your yield strength, and your measured failure strain, as shown here on this plot. Additionally, you could also talk about the mechanical behavior. At the start of our experiment down here, we see that our material has this specific width or these specific dimensions. As we load up our sample and start deforming it, you see that our material starts to stretch. And out here towards the failure of our material, we actually see a response that is commonly referred to as necking behavior. We see a localized area where the width is much smaller. So in terms of mechanical characterization, you can talk both about the properties, which provides you quantitative values, as well as the qualitative response, showing what is happening to the material, like necking behavior. Another example of mechanical characterization is shown here for determining the glass transition temperature for a polycarbonate material. This sample was tested on a dynamic mechanical analyzer, a DMA instrument. The specimen was oscillated between 0 and 10% strain as the temperature was increased. From this plot, we are able to analyze the loss modulus and the tan delta in order to determine our specific glass transition temperature for this material. A third example is for measuring the coefficient of thermal expansion, the CTE value, for a 6061 aluminum alloy. This sample was tested on a TMA, a thermomechanical analyzer. So for this experiment, a force of 0.02 newtons was held constant on the sample. as the temperature was increased. The change in length, the dL over L naught, was then measured as a function of the temperature. What you notice is that as the temperature increases, the sample length also increases. From this plot, we are able to calculate the CTE value, which at 250 degrees matches fairly well with the accepted CTE value for this specific alloy. With mechanical characterization, there are a variety of advantages and disadvantages. Specific advantages include the fact that you're able to test a large variety of materials. And for testing, you're able to obtain both qualitative and quantitative results. With mechanical characterization, there are specific ASTM standards which define your precise testing procedures and values that you should be using for different experiments and materials. There are hundreds of standards that have been, that are out there that you can specifically search for. There is probably one that relates very specifically to the type of experiment you want to run, as well as your material. And for mechanical tests, they are fairly easily repeatable. Now, some disadvantages is that with mechanical characterization, you must be able to grip or hold your sample, which can be difficult if your sample is flimsy, like a thin film, or very delicate, like a biological sample. So you must be careful when you're gripping your sample. There is no one instrument that allows you to determine all of the material properties that I listed. So you need multiple instruments in order to determine different material properties. Additionally, most mechanical techniques destroy your sample, or they deform your sample in such a way that you are not able to use it for further testing. So as long as you're okay with deforming or destroying your sample, this technique is an excellent way for determining specific material properties. Typical applications include determining your mechanical response as well as your mechanical behaviors. And commonly in processing applications, it is used for quality control or for process monitoring. As I mentioned previously, a vast array of materials can be tested, from metals, polymers, ceramics, composites, and biological samples. The size of the testing instruments range from small to large scale instruments, which allow for the ability to test different size samples. Additionally, you have other attachments and chambers that can be utilized for controlling different testing environments. Thank you.